rated M for mature.
1, 2, 3, 4. YouTube fam, man, so I got a heart back at it again with another goddamn motor vlog today, you know. Y'all chilling? Oh, shit. So, a few weeks ago, or maybe, I think it's probably been about a month now. But anyways, we're just gonna keep it this way. A few weeks ago, your boy posted a video on Instagram from, excuse me, it was a clip, or rather, it was the only footage I have left of the time when I looped the Willie. Now, when I posted up, I said that eventually I was gonna make a video about that day so I could tell you guys exactly what happened to me, how I looped it and everything. So, what I'm doing right now is I'm actually riding to the location where it happened at, so I can, like I said, so I can show you guys everything, the aftermath and all that stuff. So, before we do that, I'm gonna go ahead and play the clip for you guys. The clip, it was only available on my phone at the time because the day that it happened, that was back when the only camera I had was my Hero 4 Session. And in order to review the footage, what I did was I took the SD card out of the camera, put it into my cell phone, and I was able to copy about 15, 30 seconds of it. Now, after doing that, when I put it back into my camera, I don't know how or why, but for some reason, the rest of the footage got corrupted. So, I don't know what the fuck is going on with that. Oh, really? We got, you obviously had a red fucking light. You know you ran that damn light. Tell you, boy. Look like fucking Snowcat right now. Sheesh. What the fuck is that going with that? Yeah. So the footage from the clip I have for you guys is a little grainy, or at least when I look at it on my phone and stuff, it's kind of grainy. I haven't tried playing on my computer yet, so who knows? Maybe it'll show through a great quality for you guys. But anyways, let's go ahead and roll the clip. No!
hell. All right, the bike's okay.
Yeah, you okay. Yeah. That's the most important, man.
Let me just move it over here. I was coming up the side, and at the last second, I saw you turn your turn signal on. I tried to stop, but...
Yeah.
Go ahead, buddy. I ain't gonna start right now. Damn, y'all don't even give me a chance to get out the street?
Where I can pull this.
Good.
Got cameras on?
Yeah. Fuck. Look like I just knocked your bumper off.
You know the most fucked up thing? Let's make a video right now.
Scrape on my tank key, I guess. That's from, I can't say that's from my key. Ram out and just twist it up. Handlebars are fine. All the other shit. And bike back on. Good one to start now. Damages, but you know, here in Florida, you're not required to have insurance on a motorcycle. That's all I got, just that right there. I think what saved me was
when I saw you start turning, I kind of tried to turn with you.
Got a little, I got a little scrape on my pipe and my little frame slider here. That's fine. phone call that's gonna get me cursed out. Call my wife real quick. But no, but I ain't gonna call her. She's just gonna make things worse.
I would say car, but man, I'm sure you're gonna feel it in the morning.
I doubt it. Trust me, much worse than this. Football, wrestling in high school and stuff, weight training, I have this just great. If she asked me what happened, I'd just say I was standing on stuff and jumping off the cliff.
No insurance though.
And motorcycle enforcement?
Yep.
No insurance? Yeah. Tell him that?
Yeah, I told him. I'm going to pay for them. He's going to get an estimate and stuff.
Give me a call.
I told him, I no problem. There's no question. It was my fault. I know it was my fault.
Let's see if this should be registration.
Yes. I renewed the tag. See, I got some sticking stuff. I forgot them. Wait. Or it is. Or is this it? Yeah, this. Okay. I didn't even know I was going to have this. Always ride with a camera. Be prepared for anything. Today I was prepared and I fucked up. That simple. I'm not gonna sit here and say, oh, you fucking ass, so you can't go with the car.
up. That's why I do the job.
Tell me. Yeah. I need to start a little bit.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah.
That's
nice. You're fucking special, huh? Fuck you, boy.
I'm glad this is low speed. You see, this is why I say all the time, not filter at a high rate of speed. When I was coming up that side there, I was doing 20 or 30, I believe. I don't know. I got to review the footage, see how fast I was actually going. But
I hit on you, still went down.
YouTube, fuck. I'm in trouble, YouTube fam, hold on. Hello?
Hi.
Yes, babe. Yep, and you're gonna be upset with the reason why I'm not home. I got on a small fender bender. I was coming up the bike lane to, hold on, GPS talking. God damn it. Yeah, like I said, I was coming up the bike lane to go around traffic to get up to the front and stuff. And what happened was, as I was coming up, a guy suddenly activated his turn signal indicating that he wanted to turn. And right when I got there, like the moment I got to the corner, he turned. I hit his car. It's nothing major. I was only doing about 15 miles an hour. All I got, there's literally no damage to the bike. His front bumper got knocked off. So me, I'm actually following him to a collision center right now to see what it's gonna cost to get it fixed and stuff. Cause I told him I'd just pay for the damages. I told him I'll be able to take care of it on Friday. But he's going there now, get the estimates and everything and all that stuff. The officer left because I was so honest and upfront about it. The cop said he wasn't going to give me any citations or anything because he could have gave me at least 3 of them. Yeah, because I was upfront with him about everything and I ain't give him any BS. So he said he's going to give me the benefit of the doubt. Ain't gonna write me any tickets or anything like that. I told him we both agreed that I'll just pay for the damages and stuff. So, yeah. I mean, either way, chances are his car is gonna be fixed immediately today because it's a dealership and it's a collision center. So, you know, if they got the parts and stuff on hand, yeah, they'll fix it. But like I said, I'll give him my card info and I'll tell him to look it, man. First thing Friday morning, just send a transaction through. Yeah. No, I'm not gonna be able to kill that. That's why I'm going there with him to see what the estimate is. Cause, babe, all that happened, the bumper, it's only two of the clips that hold the bumper on his car are broken. Other than that, I was able to snap his front bumper right back on the car. So, yeah. Yeah, there's a small dent on his right fender that can be pushed out by hand, or they can fully replace it. That's why we're going there. We're gonna see, give the estimates and stuff, see what it's gonna cost to get it fixed. Like I said, there's no damage to my bike. I'm actually on it right now. I just got a small scrape on my left elbow, and I already got a Band-Aid on that, so I'm good to go. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't want to call you early because I know you would have freaked out. You would probably want to drive over there and stuff. So I was like, no, I'm just going to tell her when I get back to the house. But, yeah. I got it on camera and stuff, so you'll be able to see everything. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, I know. And the messed up thing is there's no damage to my motorcycle. And there's literally no damage to my helmet, but my visor got a scrape on the top left. Yeah. I'm like, really? I'm like, oh, at least there's no damage to the helmet. Because if my helmet would have hit the ground and would have got scratched or cracked or something, I would have had to replace it. Remember, helmets are only good for one impact, one crash. After that, get another one. Oh, and I got a little baby scratch. It kind of looked like I just scratched my knee too hard on my left knee. It looked like I just scratched it too hard as well. No, hold on, GPS talking. All right, 1,000 feet, keep left, continue on US-1 North. Where is he? Oh, he's driving a little slow. Yeah, I see him. He way back there. Yeah, he's driving a little slowly, so because apparently the flap on his bumper that's between the tire and the bumper itself is scraping his tire, so he's driving a little slowly because of that. Yeah, it's not doing anything. It's just
he said they was just making a scraping sound, so he wanted to ride slowly. And he's afraid that the wind will cause the bumper to come flying off. Because like I said, it's not bolted on, it's just, it's snapped on, it's snapped in place and stuff right now, but it's not bolted on like it should be. Yeah. I kind of left him behind a little, but we got a police report. Like I said, the cop was real cool about it, because I even said to the cop, it was my fault. I know it was my fault. I'm not going to sit here and deny it that it was my fault, because improper use of a lane, what was it you call it? Improper use of lane, improper pass, and failure to yield right of way. I could have got those three tickets. Yeah. The failure to yield right, shit, the improper pass alone, I know that's at least $125 to $150 there. Yeah, it was three tickets. That would have been a lot of fucking money. Yeah. But let's see. Here it is. It's all, the funny thing is, he actually works at AutoNation, the corporate office. Yeah, and I told him that me and my wife was considering going to AutoNation today to see about trading in our Mazda, because we're finna have a baby, see about getting us another car. So, yeah. It's just funny how all this is happening. You know what? This is AutoNation right here. Why the fuck am I finna go straight? I can just turn right here. I still don't see him. He's still way far behind. But we both got the address. We both GPS in there. So, yeah, he should be here soon. I just gotta figure out where the damn collision center is. Because he spoke to a guy named David. I'm gonna do... GPS, shut up. I'm here. Service parts collision, straight ahead. All right, here we go. Yeah, collision center. All right, so I'm here. I'm here at the place. Whoa, I see some cars that are really fucked up. Yeesh. All right, baby. I'm finna go inside, speak to the guy that he spoke to, and see what's going on. Because I'm gonna tell them the same thing I told him. I don't have the money now, but if they can, I can give them my car info and everything. They can send a transaction through first thing Friday morning. Or if they need me to, I'll go to work late and I'll come here, pay, and then go to work. Yeah. If they do, if they do, it's not going to go through. I don't have overdraft protection on my account, so if they try to send a transaction through my debit card, it's not gonna go through. Yeah. Well, I'm finna walk into the collision center now, babe. Let me call you back when I'm done here. All right, love you too. Bye.
Two hours later.
All right there, YouTube fam. So shit, holy fucking shit, man. We're just not leaving the collision center that we came to after the accident. So it was revealed to me, because I didn't notice this earlier, but yeah, he got a little scratch there on the door right here by the fender as well. So that's that there, and a little bit around front here. So apparently, in order for them to replace this whole fender and the bumper, the guy who did the estimates told us that he was at $1,300. $1,300 motherfucking dollars, man. I'm like, are you serious, dude? Because here's the thing, here in Florida,
It is not a requirement by law for a motorcyclist to have insurance. But at this shit right here, son, fuck that. I am getting me some insurance. I am definitely getting some insurance. But luckily, Waldo, he was a real cool dude, you know? So he told me that after us hearing what the estimate was, we both figured it's his best bet to just go ahead and report it to his insurance. I think he said he got Progressive. So he gonna go ahead and call Progressive to get an estimate and stuff. Well, to get them of the damages and stuff. I told him just go ahead and give me a phone call at any time. Tell me whatever the hell they tell him. And after he get his estimate and stuff, man, I told him, I know his rates aren't gonna go up because, hold on, let me adjust this. There we go. Like I said, his rates, they're not gonna go up because I was at fault. I'm not denying it. I'm not making excuses. I was at fault. I was lane filtering when it's not legal here in Florida. I was at fault. The officer, thank you, Mr. Officer Patran, he didn't write me any citations. He told me that because I was so forward and upfront with him about everything, I didn't lie, I didn't try to make anything up. I told him exactly what happened from start to fucking finish. He was a real nice cop. He could have gave me three tickets, man. Here's the tickets he could have gave me. Improper use of lane, because I was using the bike lane. Improper passing, because I was lane filtering when it's not legal here in Florida. And failure to yield right of way, because he was up front. He had the right to make a right turn because we're also in the right turning lane. So I could have got three fucking tickets today, man, totaling about $700 to $800 between those three there. And then we just, like I said, I'm just not pulling out from a dealership and stuff. And the estimated damages to his car, $1,300. So I'm like, holy fucking shit. I want to thank my lucky stars because obviously I got hella motherfucking lucky today, you guys. Got an accident, just got a scrape on my left elbow. I got on my left knee, I got a little scrape on my left knee, but hey. All right, like I was saying, I'm not sure if you guys could tell from when I showed earlier, but it's kind of scraped like you were scratching too hard and you got to a point where you end up scratching skin off and didn't realize. That's how it is on my left knee. But other than that, man, I'm okay, 100% fine. Like you guys saw, my frame slider and stuff did its job in protecting my bike. Only thing I got is a little, my frame slider is obviously scraped. I got a little scrape as well on my, my gearbox cover. At least I think that's my damn gearbox cover. I don't know much about motorcycles when it comes to mechanics and stuff. I got a scrape on the top left of my visor. I don't got the GoPro on, so you guys can't see it right now, but I'm pretty sure you guys saw it earlier in the earlier part of the video and stuff. Also, what I did was, Waldo, he actually had a laptop and stuff with him, so while we were at the dealership sitting down, I went ahead and let him connect my camera to his computer, and he got a copy of the footage. So he can go back, replay it, or whatever, whenever he wants, to see exactly what happened from start to finish, because the video, if I'm not mistaken, is over 30 minutes long. It's over half an hour. That's why when I was playing it for you guys, what I do is I fast forward all the parts where either my helmet was off or I wasn't talking about anything, because I want to put the video up unedited for you guys. It sucks that I couldn't get to down to the beach where I looped my wheelie yet, because remember, this video was originally supposed to be about me looping a wheelie, so I couldn't get to any of that. So I spoke to my wife. She's all right. She's not upset, shockingly, and I mean really, really motherfucking shockingly. She didn't go off on me or anything like, Maria, I thought it was just basically a small fender bender. I told her what happened from start to finish. I was filtering up the bike lane. You guys can even see it in the video how late it was when he activated his indicator. Little snow cat right there. Here in Florida and the States, man, we call them turn signals. But I know in California, not California, but in Canada and stuff, they use the term indicators. So yeah, we call them turn signals. But anyways, you can literally see when he activated his indicator. So you know, like, okay, yeah, I thought he was gonna go straight, but at the last couple of moments, his turn signal came on. Now, don't get me wrong, you guys. I did see his turn signal when it came on.
I did see it. I tried to apply the brake, but yeah, I wasn't good enough. I entered panic mode, pretty much froze up, and all I could do was say words. It's funny, man, when you're in panic mode, you can't really react, but you can say words. You can talk, but your mouth keeps moving, but the rest of your body like, I just stopped. Like, God damn it. Oh, well. I'm going to head home. Me and my wife finna go ahead and drive around, look at a couple of fucking apartments and stuff, because we're trying to see if I find us a place, man. And so anyways, if you guys enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave me a like down below. Subscribe to my channel if you're not already a subscriber. Once again, I'm perfectly fine, other than a hurt ego and a couple of scrapes. There ain't shit wrong with me, son, fam. So, sit for me, man. Like, damn, barely. Once again, this is being your boy, Psychotic Heart, and as for the usual, peace out, motherfuckers. Yeah! I forgot my own fucking ending. Oh, shit. Listen!